Who are you and how do you become who you are? Erikson's theory includes 8 stages of human development. Each stage consists of a unique developmental task that confronts individuals with a crisis that must be faced. In this video, we're going to be talking about identity versus identity confusion, which occurs in the psychosocial moratorium.
Psychosocial? What is that?
Well, the psychosocial moratorium is Erikson's term for the gap between childhood security and adult autonomy that adults experience as part of their identity exploration.
Okay. Isn't that the same thing as adolescence?
Well,
James Marcia developed 4 statuses of identity, which are characterized by the absence or presence of crisis and/or commitment. Thomas, a 13-year-old adolescent, has neither begun to explore his identity in a meaningful way, nor has he made an identity commitment. He is identity diffused. An 18-year-old boy's parents want him to be a doctor, so he is planning on majoring in pre-medicine in college and has not adequately explored any other options. He is identity foreclosed.
Nineteen-year-old Victoria is not quite sure what life path she wants to follow, but she recently went to the counseling center at her college to find out about different careers. She is in an identity moratorium.
Twenty-one-year-old Marcelo extensively explored a number of different career options in college, eventually got his degree in science education, and is looking forward to his first year of teaching high school. He is identity achieved.
Before they reach a stable sense of self, adolescents try out different roles and personalities. There are literally hundreds of roles for adolescents to try out, and many ways to pursue each role. Identity is a self-portrait that is composed of many pieces. The work path a person wants to follow.
Drake?
Go away.
Okay.
Whether someone is conservative, liberal, or middle of the road.
Each time we gather to inaugurate a president, we bear witness to the enduring strength of our Constitution. We affirm the promise of our democracy. We recall that what binds this nation together is not the colors of our skin, or the tenets of our faith, or the origins of our names.
Whether you're married,
divorced,
riding solo,
taken,
or other.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
one.
Comfort in the zones, the clouds and bones I get used to. A mountain is Fontaine, it's spinning in monsoon and grand. It's high octane, explosive how I came. Rolling down the hills cause life's a hassle. Encircled by my folly like a moat surround the castle. Stand flow, catch a second wind, thin is the air I breathe. Teary eyed nose running, wiping snot on my sleeve. I'm calling on the savior to be all that I need. Please forgive me, my behavior have me lost in light speed.
The ethnic identity is an enduring basic aspect of the self that includes a sense of membership in an ethnic group and the attitudes and feelings related to that membership. Adolescents from ethnic minority groups have an added dimension. They have a choice between their own ethnic group and the mainstream or dominant culture.
Some adolescents have a resolution to split through bicultural identity, which is identity formation that occurs when adolescents identify in some ways with their ethnic group and in other ways with the majority culture. Parents and siblings are important figures and have a significant influence on an individual's identity.
In a family setting, individuals have the ability to have and communicate a point of view. They can also use communication patterns to express how they are different from others. Adolescents can show connectedness in the family through sensitivity to and respect for others' views, as well as openness to others' views in the family. This is known as mutuality and permeability.
Attachment to parents also plays a role in identity development. Identity is made up of so many different components. Every little experience can have an influence on one's identity.
Twenty-one-year-old Marcelo extensively explored